We're visiting Independence Rock today. It's a granite exfoliation dome that's located about 40 miles south of Casper, Wyoming. Independence Rock is historically significant because settlers on the Oregon Trail and California Trail felt that they had to make it at least this far west by July 4th in order to be guaranteed safe passage over the far mountains of the Sierra Nevada and coastal ranges on their way to the west coast. From a geological perspective, though, we know this is a granite because it has a coarse-grained phaneritic texture, and it's composed of three essential minerals for a granite: quartz, potassium feldspar, and mica. You can see the cleavage surfaces easily on the mica and the potassium feldspar, and it's very coarse-grained texture. And of course, that implies that this rock cooled very slowly at depth as an intrusive igneous rock, where the atoms had time to migrate and build large crystals. Obviously, Independence Rock is no longer buried deep underground, so something's happened since its formation. In particular, it's been uplifted by tectonism, and erosion has removed overlying rocks from it, and a great deal of weight and pressure has been removed from Independence Rock. It's expanded as that weight was removed, and it's resulted in a particular type of mechanical weathering that we call exfoliation. In exfoliation, as the rock expands, large slabs of the rock body separate along fractures that are parallel to the rock surface and leave these exfoliation slabs behind. Stone Mountain in Georgia is another example of an exfoliation dome where this same kind of weathering is occurring. Along with the exposure of this rock, though, the extreme winds in this part of the country buffeted Independence Rock as it was being exposed and literally sandblasted polished surfaces, leaving behind features that we called wind polish or wind faceted surfaces. You can see these highly polished surfaces were a favorite place for the settlers passing through to carve their names and dates, leaving a permanent record of their time spent here. So, all in all, Independence Rock is a good model for us to identify minerals, identify a rock type, consider how and under what conditions this rock formed, and then some of its past history since then, what has happened to it since its formation in terms of weathering and erosion.